So let's move on. We're at number 33 now, book 1. Now it occurred, after Jesus had spoken these words to his disciples, that he said to them, "This is the song of praise which Pistis Sophia spoke in her first repentance, feeling repentance for her sin and recounting all that had happened to her." Let me explain here. Her sin were the sins that she committed while under the power of the archons. Now then, let the one who has ears to hear, hear. Again, Mary came forward and said, "My Lord, my light indweller has ears, and I hear with my light power, and your spirit being with me has made me sober. Incline your ear then, that I may speak of the repentance which Pistis Sophia has given, telling of her sin and all that had happened to her. Your light power has once prophesied on it through the prophet David in the 68th Psalm." Number 1, this is the Psalm. "Save me, O God, for the waters have reached unto my soul. I have sunk into the muddy depths with no place to stand, and strength has left me. I have come into deep waters, and the whirlpool is carrying me away. I am weary with my crying. My throat is parched. My eyes do fade while waiting for my God. Those who hate me without cause are more numerous than the hairs of my head, and those who would destroy me are mighty, my deceitful enemies, and what I have not taken from them, they compel me to return. O God, you yourself know my foolishness, and my sins are not hidden from you. Those who hope in you, my Lord, God of hosts, let them not be shamed by me, let those who seek you not be disgraced for me, O God of Israel. It is for your sake I have suffered humiliation. Humiliation has covered my face. I have become a stranger to my kinsmen, and a foreigner to my mother's children. Because they are jealous of your house, they do devour me, and the contempt of those despising you has fallen upon me. And with the fasting of my soul, I proceed to weep, and it came to be for reproaches to me. I make sackcloth for my clothing, and I become to them a byword. Those who sit at the gates, they talk about me, and drunkards make songs about me. Let my prayers to you, Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh, come at a favorable time, O God, in the abundance of your mercy. Answer me with the truth of your deliverance. Rescue me from the mire, and do not let me sink. Let me be rescued from those who hate me, and from the depths of the waters. Let the flood not carry me away, nor let the deep swallow me, and let not the pit close its mouth over me. Answer me, Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh, for sweet is your mercy. In your great compassion, turn towards me. And do not hide your face from your servant, for I am afflicted. Answer me speedily. Come to my soul and redeem it, because of my enemies, set me free. For you know of my reproach, my shame, and my humiliation. All my antagonists are before you. Reproach has broken my heart, and my wound is calamitous. I hoped for comfort, but there was none, and for some who would console me, but I found no one. They gave me poison for my food, and in my thirst they gave me vinegar to drink." No longer. "Let the table before them become a snare, and their peace become a trap. May their spines become eternally crooked. Pour out upon them your wrath. Let the fire of your anger outstrip them. Lay waste to their camp. Let no dweller remain in their tents. For they besiege the one whom you have struck down, and add to the pain of the wound. Visit cruelty upon their cruelty, and do not admit them to your righteousness. Erase them from the book of the living, and with the righteous ones do not inscribe them. But I am afflicted and wretched. Let your salvation, O God, come to strengthen me. I will praise the name of God in song, and I will magnify them with him with thanksgiving. And it will be more pleasing to God than a young bull with horns and split hooves. The afflicted will see it and rejoice, those seeking God. Let your hearts revive. For God hears the afflicted and does not despise the captives. Let heaven and earth praise him, the seas and everything moving therein. For God will save Zion and will build the cities of Judah, and they will settle there and inherit it. And the seed of his servants will inherit it, and those who love his name will be the ones who dwell in it. So that is a psalm, 68th psalm. 34. And when Mary had finished saying these words to Jesus among his disciples, she then said to him, My Lord, this is the solution of the mystery of the repentance of Pistis Sophia. And Jesus, when he had heard Mary speak these words, said to her, Well spoken, Mary, you blessed one, the Pleroma, or all blessed Pleroma, you who among all peoples will be praised as blessed. Again Jesus spoke and said, Pistis Sophia continued now to sing praises in a second repentance, in which she said, O light of lights in whom I have had faith, do not abandon me in the darkness until my time is ended. Help me and save me in your mysteries. Hear me and deliver me. Let the power of your light rescue me and quicken my ascension to the higher aeons. For it is you who will deliver me and guide me to the height of your aeons. Deliver me, O light, from the hand of this lion-faced power and from the hands of the emanations of the God self-willed, small g. For it is you, O light, in whose light I have had faith and in whose light I have trusted in the beginning, and I have had faith in it since the time when it emanated me forth, and you yourself caused my emanation. From the beginning, I have had faith in your light. Okay. Cause my emanation. Now, if you read the Nag Hammadi, it is said that Christ of the first luminary was the first luminary that was begotten from Barbelo, the mother of all, and Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh. So he was the first of the children. I think there were six. Yeah. She's the fourth. She was the fourth emanation. So from that first batch, as it were, you know, of children, he was the first and she was the fourth. And when I had faith in you, the archons of the aeon jeered at me, saying, She had ceased in her mystery. You are my deliverer and you are my savior and you are my mystery, O light. My mouth is filled with praise, and that I may always recount the mystery of your splendor. Therefore now, O light, do not abandon me in chaos until the end of my time. Do not forget me, O light, for the emanations of self-will have encircled me, and they have taken all my light power. They wanted to possess all my light completely and triumph over my power, saying to one another, The light has abandoned her. Let us descend upon her and seize all the light in her. And so, O light, do not leave me. Turn to me, O light, and deliver me from the hands of the merciless. Let them stumble and become feeble, and those who would seize my power, let them be engulfed in darkness and fall in weakness, those who would seize from me my light power. This, then, is the second repentance given by Pistis Sophia, singing praises to the light. 36. And it occurred, when Jesus had finished saying this to his disciples, that he said to them, Do you understand what it is I am saying to you? Peter came forward and said to Jesus, My Lord, we will not continue on with this woman, for she takes from us every opportunity, not allowing any of us to speak, but continually discoursing herself. We all understand that Peter, being the rock of the church, of the Catholic Church, always hated Mary. He despised her. And even though it's not superlatively clear in the Bible, it is very clear here. Jesus answered and said to his disciples, "Let the one in whom the power of his spirit wells up, in that he understands what I am saying, be the one to speak. Nevertheless, Peter, I see that the power in you understands the solution of the mystery which Pistis Sophia has spoken in her repentance. Therefore, Peter, speak among your brothers and sisters the design of her repentance." So even though he's not too happy with what Peter's saying, he sees that Peter has some understanding and allows him to do so. Express that, rather. And Peter answered, saying to Jesus, "O Lord, listen, that I may speak the design of her repentance, of which your power prophesied before through David the prophet in the 70th Psalm." 71st? So we're saying 70th Psalm, but in quotations it says 71st. I don't get that. That may be something to check. "In you, O God, I have taken refuge. Let me never be ashamed. Save me in your righteousness and furnish my escape. Hear me and deliver me. Become to me a God of strength, a sheltering rock to shield me, for you are my stronghold and my refuge. O my God, save me from the hand of the wicked one and from the hand of the violent and profane. For you are my hope, Lord Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh. I have trusted in you since my childhood." Excuse me. "You have sustained me since birth and guided me from my mother's womb, and always do I sing your praise. I am as a marvel for the many. You are my mighty refuge. You are my Savior, O Lord. My mouth is filled with praise of you, and I laud your splendor all day long. Cast me not off in the age of old, in the time of old age. Forsake me not when my strength fails me. For my enemies do slander me, and the ones preying on my soul do conspire against me, saying, 'God has abandoned him. Pursue him and take him, for no one will save him. O God, make haste to help me.' May they be ashamed and reach their end, those who slander my soul. May they be shrouded in shame and disgrace, those who seek evil against me." This is the solution of the second repentance uttered by Pistis Sophia. 37. The Savior answered and said to Peter, "Well done, Peter. This is the solution of her repentance. You are blessed before all people on the earth, for I have revealed these mysteries to you. Amen, amen, I say to you, I will in all the Pleroma perfect you from the mysteries of the interior to the mysteries of the exterior, and will fill you with the Spirit, so that you shall be called spiritual, perfect in all the Pleroma. And amen, amen, I say to you, I will provide you with all the mysteries of all the regions of my Father, and of all the regions of the first mystery, so that whomever you will acknowledge on earth will be acknowledged in the light of the height, and whomever you will reject on earth will be rejected in the kingdom of my Father in heaven." I will just like to say that he does not call Peter the Pleroma of all Pleromas, okay? He says, "I will fill you with the Spirit," which, of course, he needed. "But listen now, and listen with care to all the repentances that which Pistis Sophia did speak." She continued now, uttering third repentance, saying, "O powerful light, Protect me and save me. May they come to nothing and remain in the darkness, those who wish to seize my light. May they be given to chaos and made ashamed, those who would rob me of my power. May they be swiftly given to darkness, those who attack me and say, we have triumphed over her. And may instead all those who search for the light celebrate and be joyful, and those who long for your mysteries, may they forever say, glorified be that be the mystery. Rescue me now, O light. I am bereft of my light, for they have taken it from me, and I am in need of my power, for they have seized it. O light, you are my savior. You are my deliverer. O light, rescue me from this chaos. 38. And when Jesus had finished telling his disciples these things, he said, this is the third repentance of Pistis Sophia. And he said to them, let the one in whom the perceptive spirit is stirring be the one to come forward and express the solution of this repentance of Pistis Sophia. And it happened, before Jesus had finished speaking, that Martha came forward, who is Mary's cousin, and sank down at his feet and caressed them, weeping, and said with humility, my Lord, show me your mercy, and have compassion towards me, and let me speak the solution of the repentance given by Pistis Sophia. And Jesus stretched out his hand to Martha, saying to her, blessed is everyone who shows humility, for that one will receive mercy. Now then, Martha, you are blessed. Give the solution of the repentance of Pistis Sophia. Martha answered then and said to Jesus among the disciples concerning the repentance given by Pistis Sophia, O my Lord Jesus, your light power once prophesied through David in the 69th, and then it says 70th, Psalm saying, O God, speedily come to my rescue. Let them be ashamed and humiliated, those striving for my soul. May they be turned back and come to shame, those now laughing at me, ha ha. Let all those who seek you exult and rejoice in you. Let those loving your deliverance forever say, may God be magnified. Let all those who seek you exult and rejoice in you. Let all those loving your deliverance forever say, may God be magnified. Sorry, I repeated that. But I am afflicted and wretched, O God. Do come to me. My help and my rescue are you. Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh, do not delay. This is the solution of the third repentance given by Pistis Sophia, singing praises to the height. Okay, I'm just going to... Normally, I don't read stuff that Mr. Hertog writes, but this is very interesting. This is called A Confession. It's Sattva counterpart in the Book of Wisdom, which is apparently written in 50 before Christ. And in this, it's chapter 7, verse 24 to 26. And it says here, for Sophia is quicker to move than any motion. She is so pure, she permeates and permeates all things. She is a breath of the power of God, pure emanation and of the glory of the Almighty. So nothing impure can find its way into her, for she is a reflection of the eternal light, untarnished mirror of God's active power, an image of his goodness. I think I like that. And 39. Now it occurred, when Jesus had heard these words from Martha, that he said to her, Martha, and well spoken, Martha, and excellent. And Jesus continued speaking to his disciples, saying, Pistis Sophia now went on to utter the fourth repentance before she was persecuted a second time, and the lion-faced power and all its material emanations sent by self-willed into the chaos, seized the whole of her light that was left within her. She gave repentance in this manner. O light in whom I have had faith, hear my repentance, and may my voice attain your dwelling place. Do not turn your light image away from me, but protect me when they attack me. When I cry to you, do deliver me swiftly. For my time fades like a breath. I am become matter. I'm believing she's saying dark matter as opposed to light matter. My light they have seized from me, and my power is withered. My mystery, which it was my custom always to maintain, I have now forgotten. Through the vibration of fear and the power of self-willed is my own power diminished. Does that sound familiar to a lot of people? I am becoming as a separate demon, existing in dark matter with no light in him. I am becoming as an imitation spirit, finding itself in a material body with no light power in it. This is the prison. And I am becoming as a deacon, finding himself alone in the air. The emanations of self-willed have much harassed me, and my paired one said to himself, instead of with the light which was in her, they have filled her with chaos. I have eaten the sweat of my own matter and the agony of tears from the matter of my eyes, so that those who torment me cannot take what is left. It is by your command and by your order, O light, that these things have happened to me, and it is by your decree that I am here. Why would this happen? So she can learn and move out of it, obviously. Your command has brought me low, and like a power of the chaos, I have sunk, and my own power in me is paralyzed. But you, O Lord, are eternal light, and attend on all who are ever oppressed. And now, O light, stir yourself to receive my power and the soul within me. Your decree for my ordeal has been fulfilled, and now is the time for you to seek after my power and my soul. This is now the time which you have ordained to redeem me. For your saviors have searched for the power in my soul, because the number is complete, and in this way also its matter may be saved. Then will all the archons of the material aeons fear your light, and all the emanations of the 13th material aeon will fear the mystery of your light, and others may then clothe themselves in their purified light. For the Lord will retrieve the power of your soul. His mystery he has revealed, so that he may attend to the repentance of those who are in the regions below, for he has not been deaf to their repentance. This is the mystery which is the model for the generation which shall be born, and the generation that shall be born will sing praises to the height. For the light has gazed out from the height of its light, and it will appear unto all matter, to hear the cries of those in fetters, to liberate the power of the souls whose powers have been bound, so that it may plant its name in the soul and its mystery in that power. So she is saying that she understands that she went through all of this to help all those who have been trapped, to show them that there is a way out. At least that's my take on it. And I am going to leave that here for now until next time. And cheers. We'll speak again.